Be advised, the following video is used for flight simulator and entertainment purposes only. This shouldn't be used in any real-life training. Use official training materials and guides for actual aviation learning. Thank you.
Hello everyone, in today's video we'll be going through some basic understanding of the ND or navigation display. As always, if you want me to cover a topic regarding any system, feel free to leave a comment below. The navigation display, or ND, presents the pilots with most selectable flight progress data. There are 5 display modes, which can be selected by the mode selector on the EFIS control panel. You have the ROSE LS, ROSE VUR, ROSE NAV, ARC, and PLAN mode. The ROSE mode displays a 360 compass ROSE, gives you an idea of the surrounding routes and waypoints. The ARC mode only displays a forward 90 degree segment only, and PLAN mode displays the map, which is oriented in true north. Now all the mode selections have one thing in common, that's shared, which is on the top left part of the ND, which displays the ground speed, true airspeed, and the wind data, which shows you wind direction, speed, and wind arrow. Wind direction is based on true north, while the digital arrow is based on magnetic north. It's possible that the wind arrow doesn't display any given direction input and just appears blank. That's because it will only appear if the wind speed is greater than 2 knots. 4 modes are oriented to aircraft heading or heading up. If you look closely, you'll see a fixed lubber line, that's the aircraft's magnetic heading. At high latitudes, the word true will display in white. A green diamond gives you the aircraft's actual track. Of course, you have the option of going managed navigation or select a heading. You can select your heading using the flight control unit, and a blue triangle will appear. Now, if you select a heading outside of the map's range, a small heading will appear on the side of the selected heading. All display modes show range marks by white dashed lines, as for range values are shown in blue. There are 6 range settings on the EFIS control panel's range selector, which is displayed in nautical miles. Of course, if you select the farther range, you can see more from your flight plan and what's ahead. Lastly, the weather radar image can be displayed on all modes except plan. That's all for today's video. Hopefully you found this informative and interesting. Consider subscribing for more future uploads. Thanks for watching.